So if you've ever seen one of my player piano videos, you might be wondering, how on earth does this work? Well, I'm going to do my best in this video to explain that. But first, I'll have to take the covers off. So I'll do that and I'll be right back. Okay, so the covers are off. They're just right over here. And this is what the piano looks like inside. And I know in some videos I've shown the top, but I don't think I've ever shown the bottom. And the mechanism at the bottom is just as important. So essentially how it works is it's all pneumatic powered by vacuum suction, and it all starts at the bottom. So I have a manually pumped player piano. Some of them have electric vacuum pumps in them, but mine is just the standard manual one. And when you press these pedals, it generates vacuum using those exhausters, which are just like manual vacuum pumps. There's one on each side. I'll just take the roll out of there so it stops making noise. So when you pedal, it generates vacuum. But essentially when you're pumping like this with 2 feet, there are gaps between the suction, essentially when one pedal gets to the bottom. So on each side, there are these things right here. They are vacuum reservoirs, one here and one there. And they actually essentially even out the pedaling. So watch what happens. I'll tap the ground when my foot gets to the bottom. So essentially, sorry about the squeaking mechanism, but essentially, when there's a gap in the suction, the reservoir helps even it out so that there's a more constant flow of suction through the system. And then it essentially flows into this trunk up here, and it goes two places. This goes up to the upper player mechanism called the stack, and this line goes to the air motor at the top. This is the tempo governing system, which I will get to later. By the way, if you have a player piano, don't use vinyl tubing like this if these flanges are made of brass, because vinyl and brass don't react well together. These are made of lead, I believe, so it's fine, but just be careful. So on the top, the suction line flows up through here into the main stack, and then the air line for the air motor flows up there. As you can see on the back, there are a bunch of tubes coming out from the tracker bar, and each one of those goes into a little valve inside the stack, and each valve corresponds to a note. When the music passes over the tracker bar, I'll just put the roll back in to demonstrate this. When the music roll passes over the tracker bar, and when there's a note like this, it's actually a little hole in the roll. And when it passes over one of those holes, air is able to flow through the hole. And when that happens, a valve inside this valve chest, inside the stack, diverts the vacuum to a little pneumatic actuator, which actually pushes up on the piano action and causes the notes to play. Similarly to how pressing a key would actually cause the notes to play. And in this particular piano, there are, well, originally there were 86 playing notes, because the last two valves, the very bottom and the very top, were used for these, which are the dynamic controls. But when this was restored, I didn't have it restored, it was restored before I got it. The restorer didn't connect the second, like the second hole and the second last one. So essentially on the this piano, these notes don't work and these notes don't work, which is fine, because on pretty much every single roll, the top three and the bottom three notes don't work because they're used for automatic rewinds in systems. I actually do have one roll that actually does play the very top note, and it doesn't play unless I use the transposer to shift it over. In order for this to work, though, obviously, the roll needs to be moving across the tracker bar. And it moves, actually, with this air motor here. It looks like a five-chamber combustion engine, but it's essentially that with air. And on the back, you can see there's pneumatic actuators, which do the actual pumping. Essentially, this tube is the vacuum source, and these little pads here, or little blocks, are connecting the vacuum with the actual pneumatic actuator. These holes go right to the actuator, and when this passes over it, it connects the vacuum, which causes it to actuate. And yes, this piano does work with just one foot pedal working, which is a good sign. And then let's say the roll is finished. Switch this over, and then the roll can rewind. You might wonder, how does it know that you're in rewind? Why does it not play the music in rewind? Well, this little tube here is connected to the play/rewind switch. And essentially, when you put it in rewind mode, it opens a little valve in there. And that tube is connected to this point right here, which closes this valve, which does not allow air to flow into the stack. It also bypasses the tempo governing system, allowing the roll to play much faster. But when it's in play mode, the valve is closed, and air is allowed to flow through that tube, and the governing system is active. So when you adjust the tempo on the rolls, you use this lever here, which is connected via mechanical linkage to the indicator, but more importantly, is connected by another mechanical linkage to the governor. And inside there, there's a valve which lets more or less air flow into the air motor. And here's a little reservoir just for the tempo, or the air motor, I mean, which essentially evens out the air for that specific purpose. So when you are pumping a player piano, the speed of the pumping does not affect the speed of the music. Of course, you have to be pumping fast enough to actually make the piano mechanism go, but it really doesn't affect it. Watch this. So now the tempo is set really low. Roll is going slow, but as I speed up the roll, I'm not really speeding up my pumping. So the speed of the music is pretty much independent from the speed of the pumping. Next, I'll talk about the dynamic system on this piano. Older player pianos, they have a mechanical system, which essentially is like the soft pedal on an upright piano. And what that does is essentially it pushes all the hammers closer to the strings. On player pianos, usually it's split into two halves. So you'll have two levers that look like this that will essentially move the bottom half and the top half of the hammers closer to the strings. This piano was made in 1929, so it has a bit newer of a system. It's pneumatic, and it uses the top and bottom valves on the stack. So when I'm pumping, I'll just stop the music. If you lower the tempo low enough, it just stops moving. You can actually press this button, and it causes these pneumatics to push this button here. Causes these pneumatics to push the hammers closer. And of course, if you pedal, the speed of the pedaling does indeed affect the volume of the music to a certain degree. So if you want to control dynamics on this type of player piano, which is a non-reproducing player piano, you actually have to both use your feet and use the buttons, which are like soft rails. The sustain pedal, this piano does not have an auto-sustain mechanism, mainly because of the way the transposer works, but you can manually activate the sustain pedal from this here. It's a little squeaky, but as you can see, when I lift the pedals up and I release the sustain pedal, it does move the sustain lever back. So it's mechanically linked, and you can see the linkage way back there. When you push the pedal down, it lifts that little rod, and when you move this, it also lifts the rod. With this piano, with a lot of player pianos, the tracking system, it's used to keep the roll in line with the tracker bar. It will move the roll. On this piano, it actually moves the tracker bar left and right. And the reason it does that is because the tracker bar also has a transposing system. So let's say the tracker bar is moved way far away from where it's supposed to be. Watch what happens when I start pumping the piano. The tracker bar actually moves back to the right position by itself. And that's really important because the roll actually drifts left and right ever so slightly when the piano is in operation. And if you didn't have a tracking system, the music would sound like... it wouldn't sound like good music, let's just say that. How this transposing system works is there's 7 holes on each side, and by adjusting this lever, it changes which one is active. And when you change that, the tracker bar then realizes, oh, it's in the wrong position. So let's say I shift it up to the very top. It'll move the tracker bar until it's in the correct position. And that's done by those 2 pneumatic actuators there. And as you can see, this sliding block is just a valve which connects the pneumatic actuators with the correct tubing, which goes to the holes on the tracker bar. Now it's set back to the default, which is in the middle, and it'll move the bar back. Leave that there because I've already made a video of this song on my YouTube channel. I think I've covered just about everything. Otherwise, this is just a normal upright piano. It literally is just an old upright piano with a player mechanism in the top and the bottom. And when I get the piano tuned, which I have been meaning to do for a while, but I can't now with the virus situation, you actually have to take this system out, and it comes out quite easily. It's just 3 screws and a couple of tubes. The bottom system doesn't normally need to come out, but I have taken it out before just because I was curious. And when you remove those, it's just a normal piano. I have taken the piano action out before once just to fix the linkage which connects the sustain pedal to the actual action. But yeah, that's basically it. The way this works applies to some other mechanical instruments as well. That's one thing I should add. The band organ at the Lakeside Park Carousel, for example, which I visit a lot, has a Wurlitzer player system in it, which the mechanism to make the roll spin is completely different on those band organs. But the actual mechanism which makes the notes play is fairly similar to this. It has a tracker bar, it has a roll, it works with suction, and it has the valves, it uses a pneumatic actuator, but instead of the pneumatic actuator pushing on the piano action, it just pushes down on a palate valve, like which opens the airway, essentially like pushing a key on the organ. So yeah, it's the same principle. So, I hope that clears up any questions you might have about player pianos or similar mechanical music instruments, and thanks for watching.